She has been sighted walking to market above Oaxaca with strangely formed bows of firewood on her back. She is called by many names: Bone Woman, La Suera, La Trapera, the Gatherer, and La Loba, Wolf Woman. The sole work of La Loba is collecting of bones. She is known to collect and preserve, especially that which is in danger of being lost to the world. Her cave is filled with the bones of all manner of desert creatures: the deer, the rattlesnake, the crow. But her specialty is said to be she creeps and crawls and sifts through the montañas and arroyos looking for wolf bones. And when she has assembled an entire skeleton, when the last bone is in place and the beautiful white sculpture of the creature is laid out before her, she sits by the fire and thinks about what song she will sing. And when she is sure, she stands over the creatura, raises her arms over it, and sings out. That is when the rib bones and leg bones of the wolf begin to flesh out and the creature becomes furred. La Loba sings the more, and more of the creature comes into being. Its tail curls upward, shaggy and strong. And La Loba sings more, and the wolf creature begins to breathe. And still La Loba sings so deeply that the floor of the desert shakes, and as she sings, the wolf opens its eyes, leaps up, and runs away down the canyon. Somewhere in its running, whether by the speed of its running, or by splashing its way into a river, or by way of a ray of sunlight or moonlight hitting it right in the side, the wolf is suddenly transformed into a laughing woman who runs free toward the horizon. So it is said that if you wander the desert, and it is near sundown, and you are perhaps a little bit lost, and certainly tired, that you are lucky, for La Loba may take a liking to you, and show you something, something of the soul. So that was the story, and now we'll read some of the commentary by Dr. Clarissa Pinkola Estes. dismantled skeleton that lies under the sand. It is our work to recover the parts. It is a painstaking process best done when the shadows are just right, for it takes much looking. La Loba indicates what we are to look for. That indestructible life force, the bones. This cuento milagro, miracle story, La Loba, shows us what can go right for the soul. It is a resurrection story about the underworld connection to wild woman. It promises that if we will sing the song, we can call up the psychic remains of the wild woman's soul and sing her into a vital shape again. In the tale, La Loba sings over the bones she has gathered. To sing means to use the soul voice. It means to say on the breath the truth of one's power and one's need. To breathe soul over the thing that is ailing or in need of restoration. This is done by descending into the deepest mood of great love and feeling, till one's desire for relationship with the wildish self overflows, then to speak one's soul from that frame of mind. That is singing over the bones. We cannot make the mistake of attempting to elicit this great feeling of love from a lover, for this woman's labor of finding and singing the creation hymn is a solitary work. A work carried out in the desert of the psyche. Let us consider La Loba herself. The symbol of the old woman is one of the most widespread archetypal personifications in the world. Others are great mother and father, the divine child, the trickster, the sorceress or sorcerer, the maiden, youth, heroine warrior, the fool. Yet La Loba is vastly different in essence and effect, for she is the feeder root to an entire instinctual system. In the Southwest, she is also known as Old La Que Sabe, the one who knows. I first heard of La Que Sabe when I lived in the Sangre de Cristo Mountains in New Mexico, under the heart of Lobo Peak. An old witch from Ranchos told me that La Que Sabe knew everything about women, that La Que Sabe had created woman from a wrinkle on the sole of her divine foot. This is why women are knowing creatures. They are made, in essence, of the skin of the soul, which feels everything. This idea that the skin of the foot is sentient had the ring of truth, for an acculturated Quiche tribeswoman once told me that she had worn her first pair of shoes when she was 20 years old and was still not used to walking con los ojos vendados, with blindfolds on her feet. This La Loba, wild woman who lives in the desert, has been called by many names and crisscrosses all nations down through the centuries. These are some of the old names for her. The Mother of Days is the Mother Creator God of all beings and doings, including the sky and earth. Mother Nyx has dominion over all things, from the mud and dark. Durja controls the skies and winds and the thoughts of human from which all reality spreads. Coatlicue gives birth to the infant universe, which is rascally and hard to control, but like a wolf mother, she bites her child's ear to contain it. Hecate, the old seer who knows her people and has about her the smell of hummus and the breath of God. And there are many, many more. These are the images of what and who lives under the hill, far off in the desert, out in the deep. In mythos, and by whatever name, La Loba knows the personal past and the ancient past, for she has survived generation after generation and is old beyond time. She is an archivist of feminine intention. She preserves female tradition. Her whiskers sense the future. She has the far-seeing milky eye of the old crone. She lives backward and forward in time simultaneously, correcting for one side by dancing with the other. La Loba, the old one, the one who knows, is within us. She thrives in the deepest soul psyche of women, the ancient and vital wild woman. The La Loba story describes her home as that place in time where the spirit of women and the spirit of wolf meet. The place where her mind and her instincts mingle, where a woman's deep life funds her mundane life. It is the point where the I and the thou kiss, the place where women run with the wolves. This old woman stands between the worlds of rationality and mythos. She is the knuckle bone on which these two worlds turn. This land between the worlds is that inexplicable place we all recognize once we experience it. But its nuances slip away and shape change if one tries to pin them down, except when we use poetry, music, dance, or story. There is speculation that the immune system of the body is rooted in this mysterious psychic land, and also the mystical, as well as all archetypal images and urges, including our God hunger, our yearning for the mysteries, and all the sacred instincts as well as those that are mundane. Some would say the records of humankind, the root of light, the coil of dark, are also here. It is not a void, but rather the place of the mist beings where things are and also are not yet, where shadows have substance and substance is sheer. One thing about this land is certain. It is old, older than the ocean. She can take on many guises in her dreams and creative experiences. She is not from the layer of the mother, the maiden, the medial woman, and she is not the inner child. She is not the queen, the Amazon, the lover, the seer. She is just what she is. Call her la que sabe, the one who knows. Call her wild woman. Call her la loba. Call her by her high names or by her low names. Call her by her newer names or her ancient ones. She remains just what she is. Wild woman as an archetype is an inimical and ineffable force which carries a bounty of ideas, images, and particularities for humankind. Archetype exists everywhere and yet is not seeable in the usual sense. What can be seen of it in the dark cannot be seen in daylight. We find lingering evidence of archetype in the images and symbols found in stories, literature, poetry, painting, and religion. It would appear that its glow, its voice, and its fragrance are meant to cause us to be raised up from contemplating the shit on our tails, to occasionally traveling in the company of the stars. Dear friends, I hope that this has sent you into the dreamscape in the company of the stars, and that you rest